Let's see how does auto backup works in Stash. We have a custom resource named backup blueprint in Stash. It specifies which type of things to backup and the template for repositories and backup configurations. A user has to create a backup blueprint first, specifying the template properly. We need to create a storage secret containing the essential credential for the cloud storage. The backup blueprint points to the storage secret. The storage secret needs to be created in each namespaces where we will take the auto backup. Once the backup blueprint and storage secret have been created, we can create the workloads with some specific annotation for automatic backup. Stash watches the workloads. When it gets a workload with annotations for automatic backup, it finds out the respective backup blueprint. Then Stash operator resolves the backup blueprint by replacing variable fields of the blueprint with respective information from the workload. The operator creates repositories and backup configurations object for the workload according to the resolved blueprint and the annotation mentioned in the workload. Adding annotation in the creation time is not mandatory. We can add the annotations later by using kubectl annotate or kubectl edit commands. Finally, Stash starts its rest of the standard backup process. We will come with a demo video of the auto backup feature later.